I've been asked to give an opportunity to pray for the school athletes, the coaches, players, and spectators. I couldn't wait to get a hold of the paper so I could sign up to pray for these folks. I coached down Sharon Little League football for over 30 years and coached over at Bath County from two of my grandsons played over there for two or three years. But one of the players' parents asked me one day, said, what do you gotta do to be a coach? I said, one thing, love the kids. Yes. If you don't love the kids, it won't amount to nothing. If you don't love those kids. Before I pray, I want to read you a scripture from Matthew chapter 18. Starts out. About the time the disciples came to Jesus and asked, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? Jesus called a little child to him and put the child among them. Then he said, I tell you the truth, unless you turn from your sins and become like little children, you will never get into the kingdom of heaven. So anyone who becomes as humble as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of God. Amen. And anyone who welcomes a little child like this on my behalf is welcoming me. But if you cause one of these little ones who trust in me to fall into sin, it would be greater for you to have a large millstone tied around your neck and be drowned in the depths of the sea. Amen. You know, that's, in today's schools, we have some great teachers and great coaches and some really enthusiastic spectators. But maybe two. Well, I won't go further on that. But I'll probably talk with me more than anybody. But we was talking in church today about different things. But things going on in schools today. It's some bad things going on in schools today. But any of us Christian folks, we cannot afford to send our kids to these schools. I'm not talking about just in Allegheny County, I'm in Covington and Bath County. I'm talking about any school in this country without praying for heads to be around those kids. Because if we don't do that, we're throwing them into the lion's den that Daniel went into. And that roaring lion was in that, was after us today, is much more vicious than any lion ever been trapped. But that's what we have to put up with. That's what we have to pray against. And let me ask all you folks to you pray as I pray. Dear God, we come humbly before you today, pleading for our children in our public schools, especially for those playing sports. I pray for our coaches and for us fans who cheered for them. Satan has boldly and swiftly attacked our schools. Dear God, please give us Christians boldness and wisdom to kick Satan out of our school. I pray for each parent and families to pray for angels to form a hedge around their kids, for our little young athletes. Dear God, I pray that you will have our children will be so great a witness in our sports programs that Satan will flee like the coward he is. All these things I ask in thy name. Amen.
Isn't it nice to live in this community?
Mm.
When I was a young fella growing up out in the Triangle area, and I would see things on the news, and I'd always be thankful that I lived in an area where that didn't happen. I lived in a country where we were immune to things that we saw on TV when we saw bombings, when we saw all the different things in these other countries, and we could kind of sit back and think, we were immune from that. We're the United States. It'll never happen to us. Well, less than 20 years ago, we found out that we weren't immune.
Amen.
When I was sitting in my police car and got the call that we'd been attacked, we realized then that, no, we weren't immune. Today, as we watch our news broadcasts, we notice that some of our cities, we're seeing buildings being burned, we're seeing riots, we're seeing killings for absolutely no reason. And we think to ourselves, well, that's over there. It's not here. And folks, we're not immune. It can happen here, just as it does in other places. But we've got an ace in the hole, guys. Because if you think about it, there were an awful lot of folks that said, that little scrawny little fellow with a slingshot can't take that giant down. But he did. And there were a lot of folks that when they nailed Christ to that cross, and he said, it is finished. Into thy hands I commit my spirit. A lot of folks have said, that's it. It's over. But it wasn't. Because we all know what happened on that third day.
Yes.
We know that he came out of that tomb. Today, as we think about our community, and we do live in a beautiful community with not a lot of problems. But when the problems come, guess who we've got on our side? We've got that same God that fought the battles for so many of the Old Testament kings that they never even had to lift a sword. We've got the same God that, as Grover mentioned, and it was with Daniel in the lion's den, the same God that was in the fiery furnace with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the same God that came out of that tomb. We have got him with us here today. So when we worry, maybe we shouldn't, but we do, about what's going to happen in our community, don't worry, because God is with us. No matter what, God is with us. We have prayed for so many different elements of our community, and I've been asked to pray this afternoon for our entire community. Our school is just part of our community. Our churches are part of our community. And I pray for all of us, we never forget that God is part of our community.
Yes.
Let us pray together. Father, as we gather here this afternoon, recognizing that there are lots of issues that face us, but your word told us it wasn't going to be easy. Your word told us we would face trials and tribulations, but you also told us that no matter where we went, you were with us. If we were on the top of a mountain, you're there. If we're in the bottom of the valley, you're there. And no matter what comes our way, you're right there with us. Father, today I pray for this community. I pray for all of us, for everyone that lives here, for everyone that comes through this community. That you keep us safe, that you protect us. And Lord, may the power of your Holy Spirit fill our hearts to know that you are our God, that you love us so much, enough to send your very Son to die for us. Lord, we pray today for the protection that you will give our community, that you'll give our schools, that you'll give our offices, our teachers, our administrators, everyone that has been mentioned this afternoon. Lord, I pray for this community. Bless us as we strive to serve you first and to serve each other. In the name of Christ, amen.